Growing up in Southern Africa, surrounded by a lot of wild areas, as a child I used to go into the South African veld, as we call it, and kick over stones and collect all kinds of things. I was interested pretty much in everything, but I was particularly interested in creepy crawlies and snakes and lizards and spiders and scorpions. I became more and more fascinated with scorpions in particular over time, and was lucky enough to find a person who was willing to support me to do a PhD degree specializing on Southern African scorpions. My work is focused on primarily discovering and describing new species, going out into nature and finding these animals, understanding how they're distributed geographically over the landscape, and then also understanding how they evolved. Some of the most interesting scorpions are in really inaccessible places, you know, down in caves in Mexico, you know, up to a kilometer below the surface, or you know, in the middle of the Sahara. I've had all kinds of experiences on these trips, from being shot at by policemen in Puerto Rico to having run-ins with farmers who accusing us of stealing their sheep in South Africa, encounters with lions and leopards. The best way to find scorpions, particularly in desert areas, is to go out at night with ultraviolet lamps when the scorpions are active. You have to go out on pitch dark, moonless nights with your ultraviolet lamps and your torches. Scorpions come out on the surface and you pick them up. It has to be absolutely dark and nice and warm. In Central Asia, I was stung by a very severely venomous scorpion. There were so many scorpions, I literally would just have enough time to pick up one, put it in the bottle, bend down, pick up the next one. And I got careless and I picked up an extra large specimen, and as it was going into the bottle, I guess I was looking for the next scorpion, it grabbed onto the mouth and stung me right in the thumb. And that was the end of my scorpion collecting for that night. I knew immediately that I was going to be in severe pain, probably pretty ill, and I took a whole lot of antihistamines. So I just went to my tent and lay down and basically endured the pain for hours and hours. And more recently, I've also started looking at solifugs or camel spiders, also known as wind scorpions, a variety of other names. This is a bizarre group of arachnids. They've got the largest jaws for their size in the animal kingdom. There are only about two or three experts on them worldwide, and they've hardly been studied. I would like to see more people get interested in these creatures, start to appreciate, what incredible creatures these are.